Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. To begin our evening, please remain standing as we welcome the Yonkers Police Department Color Guard, led by Captain Leahy. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Jessie Popper, daughter of Deputy Mayor Sue Gary, as she leads us in our Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please welcome the Yonkers Children's Choir, led by Cecilia Myers, who will lead us in the national anthem. One more round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the Yonkers Police Color Guard, Jessie Popper, and the Children's Choir of Yonkers. All right, most importantly, you may be seated. On behalf of Mayor Spano, thank you so much for joining us here tonight at the 2017 State of the City Address for the City of Yonkers. Under the leadership of Mayor Spano, alongside Yonkers City Council, the Board of Education, and the entire city, Yonkers has witnessed tremendous growth and improvements over the past 5 years. We've seen new businesses born and development built in every corner of the city. From the education of our children to the environment we cherish, our public advocacy campaigns have earned bipartisan support and gained thousands and thousands of followers this past year for our causes and for our initiatives. Our quality of life in Yonkers is healthier. Our streets are safer. Our schools are thriving. And our city has never been more diverse. And most importantly, the future is brighter for the generations to follow. The mayor's vision 5 years ago was to make Yonkers a better place. From this vision and the hard work of countless Yonkers residents, most of whom are in this room or watching tonight, you've seen a lot of action. But most importantly, you've seen a lot of results. We are one family. We are one Yonkers.
Let them know that we want Yonkers schools rebuilt. That there are businesses coming to Yonkers that if you come here 30 years ago, they would come here and say, what can you give us to come here? Now when businesses come here, they don't really want all that much. They just want me to find them property. Find me property. We want to be a part of all the great things that are happening here in Yonkers. Represents us. Our diversity is truly our strength.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 42nd mayor of the city of Yonkers, Mayor Mike Spano.
Thank you all. Good evening, Council President McLaughlin, Majority Leader Larkin, Minority Leader Sabatino, and members of the City Council, members of the Judiciary who are here with us today, the Board of Education Trustees, our Superintendent of Schools, teachers and students, state and county representatives, city commissioners and board members, and of course, fellow Yonkers residents. I'd like to thank those watching live on News 12, Files 1, or any of you are watching online. And a special thank you to our city's First Lady, my wife Mary, our children, Michael, Alexandra, and Christopher, who are stuck watching me tonight. But before we begin, let's give the Yonkers Children's Choir another round of applause. You know, this is the sixth time we've gathered here to talk about our city. And I hope you feel, as I do, that you are among family and friends. Many of you know that I come from a very large family, but I know my relatives hate that picture, by the way. So, but I tell people they don't know the half of it. I'm really part of the biggest family of all, and that's the family of Yonkers. The idea that Yonkers is a family has always guided me as mayor. A family looks out for one another, works together, stands together in good times and in bad, and is always working towards a better future. The family of Yonkers seems more important than ever. You know, the national discussion seems to be about division. Our leaders appear more interested in pointing fingers than extending a helping hand. Here in Yonkers, we do better than that. Yes, we can be scrappy and passionate about our politics, but we don't lose our respect for one another. We have more ethnic and political diversity than most, but we don't let it get in the way of our common goals. We speak many languages in this city, but the one language we all have in common is respect, and respect for one another, and a determination to work together to make Yonkers a better community. Now, how is Yonkers doing, you might ask? After 5 years of telling you where Yonkers is headed, I can say today we have arrived. After 5 years of plans to solve our problems, we can now say that those solutions are working. After 5 years of steering past the storms, today we are on a favorable course with the wind at our back. Let's begin with public safety. Yonkers remains one of the safest cities in the nation, and according to the FBI statistics, Yonkers moved up again. We moved up from third safest city to the second safest city of our size in America. We plan to even do even better. You know, 22% of all crime in our city takes place in just two sectors of the third and fourth precincts. So by creating a new police precinct, which we will call the fifth precinct, and using existing resources, we can target these areas and drive down the crime rate even lower. The existing precinct and sector car boundaries were drawn up, you know, many years ago, and it's time to adjust them to deal with today's facts as they are on the ground. Our police department has acquired its first bloodhound. Her name is Callie, and she's already helped us find a person who was threatening suicide. Using a piece of clothing, she tracked down this individual to a wooded area from where we were able to get him assistance, and he's doing fine. She's doing such a great job that I recognize Callie as the first non-human employee of the month back in December. Callie is with us tonight. Where's Callie? And we'd like Callie to come out and be recognized. Come on, Callie. You're a great addition to our team. We are also working to ensure that our pedestrians are safe when walking our streets. And starting this spring, the Yonkers Police Department will distribute free reflective armbands to residents who routinely walk, run, exercise after sundown. We're calling it Be Seen Yonkers. So be on the lookout for these. They can save a life. For many years, drag racing has been a problem on some of our major streets, Central Avenue in particular. It's a public safety issue, and a few years ago led to the tragic shooting of an innocent young man from our city. It's not enough to cite drag races for traffic violations. Fortunately, we now have a new tool on our side. Going forward, we will be able to confiscate the vehicles of those who engage in drag races. Get caught once, and you won't be able to use your car to do it a second time. Special thanks to the Majority Leader John Larkin and the entire City Council for helping us out on this critical new law. If you've been downtown recently, you might have noticed a new member of our fleet. We recently rolled out two new Segway patrollers. And with these patrollers, police officers are more visible and approachable than they are in cars. They are also instrumental for larger community events such as the 4th of July celebration, Riverfest, and National Night Out. Take a look at our Segways in the lobby, please, on your way out, but no riding them. And that means you, Vinny. But it's okay if the council president wants to do it. Just don't forget to wear a helmet. Our fire department is the other half of our public safety service, and we continue to make sure that they have the best equipment to do their job. Last month, we unveiled six new pieces of fire apparatus, and these new engines and ladders cost more than $4 million and are specifically designed for Yonkers. They run cleaner and more fuel efficient. They also have steering mechanisms and drivetrains that are designed to make the tight turns and go up those narrow climbs of those hills that we call Yonkers. Tonight, I am pleased to present the design of our long-awaited downtown firehouse. It will be located on School Street and cost an estimated $10 million. It will replace Station 1, which, as we know, not only is unsafe, but is economically beyond repair. But I intend to present this to the City Council in this year's budget. It's essential that our public safety forces represent the diversity of our beautiful city. In recent years, we've made great progress in recruiting minorities. Since 2012, we've seen a nearly 200% increase in female applicants, a more than 50%, that's right. A more than 50% increase in black applicants and a nearly 90% increase in Hispanic applicants. You know, the word is out, everyone has the opportunity to protect and serve the city of Yonkers, and that's the way it should be. Let's give our first responders who routinely risk their lives for us a special round of applause. Let us also not forget those who take care of our streets, our schools, and help run our government facilities. Thank you, everyone, for your service. Let us also recognize the ultimate sacrifice made by one of our young Yonkers residents, New York City Fire Chief Michael Fahey, who died in the line of duty in September. A humble, generous family man, Chief Fahey exemplifies what it means to be a public servant. He never hesitated for a moment to put himself in harm's way to help others. His wife Fiona and their children Michael, Anna, and Cormac continue to carry on in Michael's memory. And I just want to, just for a moment, recognize them and say that Mike will always be in our hearts and prayers. Thank you. You know, Yonkers is a great place to raise a family, and it seems plenty of other people know it too, because our schools continue to grow with more students every year. This year, we enrolled 26,607 students, an increase of approximately 100 from the year before. Our schools are not only growing in size, but in achievement. Once again, we led the Big Five cities in graduation rates. Our current graduation rate of 82% is not only the best in the Big Five school districts, but is above the average for the entire state. You know, our schools are doing an incredible job. Why not? We have incredible teachers, we have incredible administrators, and most of all, incredible parents and students. We also have some wonderful partners, such as the partners or the Yonkers Partners in Education, which brings people from all over Westchester to act as mentors for our high school students and prepare them for college and provides after-school tutoring at the College Zone. This program is doing so well that we have more high school seniors wanting to take part than we have mentors available. So if you just have, just an hour every other week to spend with a high school student to help them get into college, call Yonkers Partners in Education. They'd love to hear from you. Thank you. You know, for years we've talked about bridging the digital divide that can be prevalent in our community. And this year, the talk is over. We have another partner in education, Altice USA, which recently purchased Cablevision. We recently reached an agreement which Altice will provide reduced price modem and discounted internet service to every child whose family's economic status qualifies them for a free or reduced price lunch. A little bit of tongue twister, but I got it. That's about 79% of all of our students, and it means they will be able to get high-speed internet at home for their homework. Now, utilizing E-rate dollars, the city will also contribute towards the cost of internet service for low-income students. So the ultimate cost would be less than $6 per month for our families. You know, the digital divide can seem as wide as the Grand Canyon to a student who can't use the internet at home. And this partnership will close that divide here in Yonkers. And thank you, Altice, for helping our young people become scholars. We continue to improve our efforts to help newcomers to our schools learn English, which we all know is the first step towards succeeding as a new American. To help the growing number of older students who are coming to Yonkers from other countries, our school district has created a high school international academy for recently arrived English language learners in grades 9 and 10. The international academy will provide the best possible transition to English for these newcomers. We've also created a dual language program for kindergarten and pre-kindergarten. The purpose behind this is that by the time our children are in elementary school, they will already be proficient in English so that they won't fall behind. You know, immigration policy is a national debate these days and one that seems to be dividing our nation. Here in Yonkers, we have our own immigration policy, and it consists of just three words. You are welcome. Yonkers has embraced immigrants for as long as we've been a city, and we are not about to stop now. My grandfather was one of those immigrants. If you are a refugee fleeing persecution, a parent who wants a better life for your children, or a laborer who wants nothing more than to earn a decent wage for an honest day's wage, we do not turn you away. We do not fear you. We do not demonize you. We do not blame you for problems that are not of your making. Instead, we welcome you. We are honored that you chose our city as a place to start your new life, and we look forward to enjoying the many benefits of your contributions to our community. We don't say go away, we say welcome, neighbor. That is Yonkers way. And there is no place more important to demonstrate that than in our schools. We are also expanding our career and technical education programs in high schools. We want every student who wants to go to college to be able to do so. Yet many of the good jobs in our economy do not require college, but instead adequate trade and technical training. You cannot just show up and get a job as an auto mechanic because there's a lot more to modern engines than just changing a few spark plugs. Right, Johnny? My brother Johnny knows all about that. We are providing more technical training so that our graduates will have the ability to go on to specialized trade schools and can lead a lifetime of success. I also want to talk about sports in our schools. It was wrong, actually, when our sports programs were virtually eliminated many years ago. Sports build character and provide lessons in working together. We have begun to bring sports back, and this year we instituted and intramural programs for grades 7 and 8, and in the near future, we plan to bring back the JV teams. We will not stop until the young people of Yonkers have the full opportunities of sports once again. You know, in 2014, President Barack Obama issued My Brother's Keeper Challenge to the mayors of every community in America. In 2016, Yonkers became one of 250 communities to accept this challenge establish a My Brother's Keeper program. My Brother's Keeper recognizes the harsh reality that young men of color are at a higher risk to fail in school. That's often the first step to a lifetime of poverty, as well as an increased chance of incarceration. The goals are simple. We want our young men of color to graduate from high school ready for college and a career to complete a post-secondary education or training and to successfully enter the workforce. Led by our our fantastic superintendent of schools, Dr. Edwin Quesada, Dr. Jim Bostic, executive director of the Nepean Community Center, and Yonkers Thrives, MPK Yonkers, has already hit the ground running. And please join me in recognizing our Yonkers Public School students who are already engaged in My Brother's Keeper. They are making a difference, and let's give them a round of applause. We also know that unplanned pregnancy among young people continues to be a problem. That's why we are entering into a nationally recognized partnership with Montefiore Health System and Planned Parenthood to ensure the health of both mothers and their newborns. The Nurse Family Partnership Program will assist first-time mothers and low-income families. A nurse will be matched with an expected mother, providing guidance throughout a pregnancy and continue until the child is 2 years old. The first ever in Westchester County, this program will concentrate on maintaining healthy lifestyles, avoiding future unplanned pregnancies, and working on strategies so that the mother can continue her education so she can get back into the workforce. Working with Councilwoman Corazon Pineda Isaac, Yonkers will be providing funds to get this program started. The Board of Regents has finally joined our long-standing call to address the disparity between wealthy districts and poor. Why should a student's zip code determine if he or she is in a modern classroom with a teacher for every 20 students, or an ancient classroom with a teacher for every 30 students? Why should a student's zip code determine whether or not they have the ability to a library, to enough guidance counselors, to adequate special education to help overcome a learning disability, or sports and extracurricular activities? It's time for the state of New York to recognize its constitutional duty to provide an equal and adequate education for every child in this state. That means ending the divide between wealthy and non-wealthy districts. There should be no reason why a child from Yonkers receives 25% less than a child who lives on the other side of the Bronx River Parkway. We all know that our schools are also among some of the oldest in the state, and we once again turn to our plan to rebuild our schools. Last year, we made great progress with our Rebuild Yonkers Schools campaign, and we want to thank our governor and the legislature, especially our state delegation, for establishing the Yonkers School Construction Board that can issue bonds and begin the job of rebuilding our schools. But we need to be clear. We need the state to take the next step, which is to provide Yonkers with the same amount of building aid that goes to upstate cities, such as Buffalo, Rochester, and Syracuse. It is wrong that the state pays 98% of the reconstruction costs, but less than 70% of the reconstruction costs for us. I want to thank our parents, our teachers, and members of the community who continue to reach out to our elected representatives in state government to remind them how important this is for our young people. We are urging our community, especially our students, to share and tag their legislators with hashtag fund to rebuild. Some of you are probably tired of hearing me saying this. Let them hear your voices. I promise you, this goes a long way. I hope you all grabbed a Rebuild Yonkers Schools wristband on your way in tonight. Let us be united and display our school pride. I know I do. Everybody got theirs? All right. You know, we can never be too concerned about school safety. So we must be best prepared for the worst case scenario. This year, we are establishing a new state-of-the-art school security system which links all cameras, alarms, and lights to police and to a citywide security platform. We've held numerous interagency tabletop exercises, active shooter drills in the schools, and a new security officer training, all done under the direct supervision of the Yonkers Police Department. We hope the scourge of violence never hits our city, but we are prepared in the event it does. The city is where a lot of people come to live, and there are more people coming to live in Yonkers than ever before, thanks to the successful effort to work with our investors and our builders. The statistics tell the story. As recently as 2014, the Planning Board approved just 104 units of new housing. In 2015, that number increased to more than 1,000 units as HBR Club, the RXR Tower, the Mill Creek Development, and others were approved. Now, last year, we had an amazing 2,800 units of new housing were approved, including the Waterfront Avalon Bay Project, Wilburton Avenue, Extel, and Jackson Street. That's nearly 4,000 units of new units under development right now. That's a 5% increase of the city's total number. That's it, planning and all of you have done such a great job with that. That's an incredible record, but we're not done yet. There are also more people than ever who come to stay in Yonkers for a day or two, since now we have the 1,000 nationally branded hotel rooms throughout the city. So feel free, for those of you who don't live in Yonkers, hang out. The online magazine, The Real Deal, is the Bible of the regional real estate industry, and Yonkers seems to be showing up in it more than ever these days. Most recently, they said our city was part of the Hysteria vertical growth trend. Millennials and empty nesters alike are expected to fill up the new high-rises that the developers are building. We have begun the next phase of our Generation Yonkers regional land campaign, and Yonkers has joined the interest of more than 50 new businesses since we began those ads, telling the entire New York area what a great place Yonkers is to live, to work, and to play. That means more jobs, more tax revenues, and continued strength in our city's economy. The message is working. The Generation Yonkers campaign is resonating beyond the regional market. Yonkers was one of only three cities in New York State to make the top list of cities for millennials. You know, we have to compete with the entire tri-state area when it comes to attracting investment, and telling our story is an essential first step in generating interest. So let's pause for just a moment and take a look at one of the latest ads.
How's business in Yonkers? Booming.
That's Chef Christian Petroni, renowned chef, restaurateur, TV personality, and owner of Fortina Restaurants.
Yonkers is in the center of this renaissance that's happening. We really wanted to be a part of it, and I'm honored to be here. That same energy that started happening in Brooklyn about 10 years ago is happening here. I feel it germinating.
A city with all the right ingredients for business success. Be part of Generation Yonkers.
I am so excited to be a part of Generation Yonkers.
Thank you to Christian Petroni, who's joining us here tonight. Christian, where are you? Thank you for your investment in our community, and we're looking forward to your opening next month. Although we welcome new housing and development, we also need to recognize our obligation to provide quality homes for our public housing residents. Most of the city's public housing is between 45 and 60 years old, and almost all of it needs upgrade. That's why the Yonkers Municipal Housing Authority is investing up to $250 million over the next 5 years to repair and renovate 1,773 units throughout the city. And I want to thank the MHA Director, Joe Schillender, Chairman Judge Doran, and the rest of the board for leading this project. I know our residents are in good hands. Thank you. We also have to recognize our responsibility to help the homeless. So we refuse to stand by and watch the county government run overcrowded and unsafe shelters in our downtown. We succeeded in getting the county to agree to safer conditions at one of its shelters. We've instituted new regulations which require fire safety training for all shelter operators, just as they do in New York City. It is my goal to ensure safer and more humane conditions in our shelters. And we've made great strides when it comes to caring for the homeless. And I vow we will continue to be vigilant. We are expanding our award-winning Soar Mill River daylighting program, which has already transformed the character of Larkin Plaza. Construction on phase three will begin this spring as we extend this unique urban park to New Main Street, just behind City Hall. The Soar Mill River daylighting is becoming the central feature of a newly rejuvenated business, recreational, and residential district. To heighten the experience for anyone visiting the daylighting, we recently launched Experience Yonkers. It's an urban light and sound display featuring music and videos that are related to the Yonkers experience. Yonkers can be seen and heard on the exterior wall of this particular library or on the sidewalks of Getty Square and under the Main Street overpass. This is popular in Europe. Yonkers is the first city in the United States to permanently install and display this type of technology on a full-time basis. Thank you for taking care of it. Another continuing attraction to the downtown is also right here at the Riverfront Library. We recently opened Tech Central at the library, which is a series of labs for learning, creating, and communicating. You can take courses, you can hold conferences and workshops, and you can create media projects, all using the latest equipment. Among my favorites are the 3D printers. So if you can think of something, you can design and create it in plastic using a 3D printer. I've already printed my very own bobblehead collection. What do you think? Some of you guys aren't laughing. In all seriousness, many of the successes that we've had here in the city would not have been possible without the great work of this city council. And I want to extend my appreciation to each and every one of them. We are also completing the effort to sell the many vacant buildings and lots that the city had acquired for non-payment of taxes over the years. A vacant building or a lot is not only an eyesore, but it's a drain on our tax rolls. In the past 5 years, we have sold surplus buildings and land in the amount of about $20 million and have collected $9 million from the sale of property acquired through tax lien foreclosures. Thank you, Mike Curdy. That's right. You know, the days of deadbeat properties are over as we aggressively put them back in action. And for the buildings that are still vacant, but whose owners are still paying property taxes, our vacant registry is proving to be a potent tool to make sure that they are properly maintained in the meantime. Next month, one of our most well-known vacant buildings of all is opening as a new mixed-use office and retail center. And I'm talking about the Boyce Thompson property along Northborough Way, which was vacant for nearly 40 years. For most of the time, city leaders have been promising to revive it, and it's one of the first promises that this administration made, and I'm proud to say that we got it done. Now, let's take a look at Boyce Thompson and see what it looks like today. Let's also thank the Simone Development Group for having the vision and the dedication to make a showcase out of this property while managing to preserve its historic character. Last year, we discussed the expanding Ridge Hill Shopping Center. I'm happy to say we will soon cut another ribbon on a national retail store, this time Lowe's, the first ever in Westchester County. And despite all that is happening, there are even more plans for the future. One of the most exciting is to propose Yonkers Sports and Events Center at iPark, which is the location of the old former Otis Elevator Factory. The center would be developed by the not-for-profit Armory Foundation. We've already received $2 million towards the $25 million estimated cost from the State Regional Economic Development Council. The center would include a 5,000 to 6,000 seat complex, as well as an educational center and a restaurant. The center would attract people from all throughout the region, and we pledge our full support to the Armory Foundation to make this happen. I should note that, unfortunately, last week, founder, president, and CEO of the Armory Foundation, Dr. Norbert Sander, passed away. Dr. Sander was a pioneer in track and field. He was the only New Yorker ever to win the New York City Marathon, and until his untimely passing, continued to be one of our loudest cheerleaders in promoting running, health, and fitness. We pledge to continue his work in his name. We have also auctioned a long-vacant city building at 70 Pier Street, directly adjacent to the Ludlow train station. I'm happy to announce the winning bid for this project is the Ginsburg Organization, one of the region's major developers and one that has built a number of successful projects right here in Yonkers. Ginsburg proposes apartments whose residents could walk out the door and travel to jobs in New York City or head north. The riverfront views would be astounding, and this new market rate housing on the north end of Ludlow Park will provide a revitalization anchor for one of our city's oldest neighborhoods. While our economy continues to evolve and tourism is becoming significant, and why not? We have a great museum, we have a casino. We have some of the best shopping centers, a magnificent waterfront, I got that out, with outstanding restaurants and galleries, a historic botanical garden, and many biking and hiking trails. We've established the Yonkers Tourism Alliance a year ago, bringing together the hotels, restaurants, and retailers, and the cultural centers to promote the city's ever-increasing offerings. Now, we're taking the next step, and we'll be holding our first ever Yonkers Tourism Expo in April, so remember, in April at Empire City. Our waterfront continues to be the focus of our revitalization efforts, and with the expanding commerce and new housing popping up along the Hudson, it not only makes sense to bring our people to the water's edge, but also to bring boaters there as well. So I'm excited to announce that we will be working with the development community to access grants to expand our piers along the downtown waterfront and JFK Marina. A new pier can serve as a launch point for dinner cruises, river excursions, and private boaters. The Hudson is our greatest asset, and we all should enjoy it. The centerpiece of our city's growing reputation is being a center for the arts, which is amazing to me because 3 years ago we established the Yonkers Arts Weekend, which we did kind of as an experiment. It now attracts more than 10,000 visitors a year to our downtown galleries as well as art exhibits throughout the entire city. We just announced our call for artist submissions to exhibit at this year's event, May 6th and May 7th. So for the artists in the room, keep that date. We also know our Hudson River Museum continues to reinvent itself. And earlier this year, native and resident of Yonkers, Masha Tuchinski, she's the new museum's director. So Masha is here with us. Masha, stand up. And I want to say thank you. Thank you for promoting the arts, especially the diverse arts in our culture. Our city's finances continue to be a challenge, and it's one we must meet head on. Our bond ratings were upgraded once again this year by both Moody's and Standard & Poor's. Both now give us an A rating with a stable outlook. The immediate effect of these improved ratings is to reduce the cost of us issuing bonds, so to reduce the cost of us borrowing money. That message is that after years of financial instability, Yonkers is getting back on track, We are living within our means. Our economy and our tax base are growing. Yonkers, not unlike most other major cities in America, has a city budget that will require us to look at every city service to see where is it we can save dollars. The cost of health care, union contracts, and pensions continue to outpace revenue and growth, and not to mention municipal aid from New York State has remained flat for the last 7 years. I expect that the budget we will shortly unveil will be another challenging one. And not unlike previous years, we will make some hard choices, but we will remain fiscally responsible and continue on a path towards stability. Among our challenges are the aging sewer and water systems. And like you, and as a homeowner, one of my biggest fears is a possible break in an underground pipe along my property and not having it covered by my existing insurance. Well, I'm happy to say that help is on the way. Partnering with America Water Resources, we will soon create a program which homeowners can take out low-cost insurance that will cover the cost of repairs. It will be voluntary, but it will provide peace of mind against the possibility of unforeseen damages that can cost a homeowner thousands of dollars. I know Dennis was looking for that. We know that the property tax burden remains high, especially for moderate and middle-class homeowners. Rather than look to raise taxes even higher, we are turning our attention to those who currently pay no taxes at all. Now, before you get nervous, you have to hear this, right? Many major property owners, such as colleges, hospitals, cultural institutions, and not-for-profits are exempt from all property taxes. Yet, we must still provide the services to them to the tune of $20 million a year. Our police and fire respond to emergencies. We maintain the roads that they use, provide adequate streetlights to light the way, and collect the trash, and the list goes on. We are going to propose that any institution with property worth more than $1 million consider a, need you to hear this, voluntary payment in lieu of taxes. We would expect no more than 25% of what they would otherwise pay in property taxes. Just so you know, we're not the first to do this. Many other communities like Boston, Baltimore, and Pittsburgh that face similar financial challenges have partnered with their major tax-exempt institutions in this very same way. And knowing how dedicated our many great institutions are to the city, we are hopeful that this voluntary effort will help keep Yonkers a great home for many, many years to come into the future. Among the crown jewels of Yonkers are our parks. And again, this year we will continue to improve them. We are rehabilitating the playground at Gramerton Hill, resurfacing the tennis courts at Schultz and Kingsley Park, and renovating the restrooms at Redmond Field. You may also have noticed the new digital welcome sign on Tuckahoe Road near Mary's Skating Rink. Our Parks Department is also partnering with our schools to begin, this is very exciting, especially for our kids, a horticultural program. Special education students from Lincoln High School, as well as the students from Westchester School for Special Children, will assist the Parks Department as they grow and nurture plants in our greenhouses that will be planted at Untermyer Park and throughout the city. And this is a great way for our children to connect with their environment. The environment is important to us all. We continue to reduce the city's carbon footprint, not to mention our electricity bills. And by replacing even more older lights with energy efficient and brighter LED lights, we are now moving this project into our schools. Again, partnering with the New York Power Authority, we replaced 10,000 light fixtures in our schools with LED lights, and we're now over 30,000 citywide. That will save us an estimated $356,000 a year in energy bills, not to mention all the time that we are going to save by not having to constantly replace those old bulbs. We've also established an environmentally preferable purchasing policy in all city departments that emphasizes products that minimize health impacts and the use of toxins. We are also installing 9 more electric vehicle charging stations free to the public. And we will be incorporating electric vehicles in our city's own fleet. We also want to increase the city's refuse recycling rate. You know, we currently recycle about 45% of our waste, and that's well above the EPA's goal of 35%. But it's still way below the Westchester-wide average of 53%. So to encourage more recycling, we will provide free new recycling bins to interested residents on a first-come, first-served basis, along with information on how to recycle. You know, recycling is not only good for the environment, but it's good for you, the taxpayer, because every ton that we recycle saves us money in what they call tipping fees or dumping fees at the county's resource recovery plan. So, you know what? The more we recycle, the less our costs will be. Last year, led by City Council President Liam McLaughlin, we announced the beginning of our anti-littering campaign. We call it Respect Yonkers. You may have noticed some of the bright, clever signage throughout the city on all of our garbage cans and some of the bus stops. But like recycling, we can still do better. This year, to promote the campaign to those who will inherit our city, the Yonkers Public Schools and the Council President are holding an essay and poster contest to help our kids understand the importance of promoting anti-littering and recycling. So I want to say thank you to our Council President for your leadership. You know, our city is our home, and we should never want to fill it up with litter. And just as we don't want our city to be home for litter, we don't want our wonderful Hudson River to be a parking lot for oil barges. I'm proud to say that Yonkers took the first step by forming the Hudson River Waterfront Alliance to stop the federal government's insane plan to create 10 new anchorage locations near Yonkers and other waterfront communities here in Westchester. There's a surplus of oil, and the barges have no place to unload. So they want to stack them up all along the Hudson River in front of our community. Besides increasing the risk of spills, everything we've done to improve our waterfront will be offset by the sight of oil barges that are moored alongside our shoreline for months at a time. And area communities agree, and I'm pleased to say that over 30 different municipalities representing over 700,000 residents in Lower Hudson Valley have rallied for our cause. We will stop this plan. And I want to thank Congressman Elliot Engel, Sean Patrick Maloney, along with other area elected officials who have joined our effort. Thank you. If our city and our streets seem a little more crowded these days, it's because they are. We've all talked about all the new development that has taken place or is underway in Yonkers, about the new people coming to live and to work and to play here. That also means more traffic. So if you are like me, you've noticed how long it takes to drive through Yonkers. We are completing better signalization and turn lanes on Ashburton Avenue, but we need to undertake a study of Tuckahoe Road, Southborough Way, Yonkers Avenue, and other key arteries whose travel times are just too slow. In some cases, it's a matter of better timing for traffic lights, and in others, we may need more turn lanes or even more drastic measures. So we intend to begin the process this spring and identify a priority list for improvements. We also acknowledge the many sacrifices made by our many veterans who served our country. And this year, I had the distinct honor and privilege of meeting a true American hero from the Greatest Generation, former Tuskegee Airman Charles Lovelace Lewis, a Yonkers resident. Mr. Lewis was a communications technician in the first Black Aviator unit in the U.S. Armed Forces during World War II. Mr. Lewis and his mates, they battled racism and won. He reminds us that despite any injustices that we may face, we must continue to defend our beliefs and our freedoms as a country, because we are one nation, united under one flag. please join me in recognizing Mr. Lewis and all the veterans. Please stand up and let's say thank you for your courage and service. Now, I've outlined an ambitious agenda this evening, but I've also listed an incredible number of things that we've already achieved, each one made possible by those who serve our government and our schools, by our incredible community leaders and the volunteers, as well as business leaders and investors who have put their time and resources into our Yonkers. We've got 4,000 units of housing being built or under construction. Our city's bond ratings have gone from near junk rating to an A rating. Our unemployment rate is down to 5%. That's almost half the rate that it was just 5 years ago. More than $1 billion in private investment and dozens upon dozens of new companies have flowed into Yonkers. Our schools are now beating the state's average when it comes to graduation rates. We are one of the safest cities of our size in the United States of America. We have restaurants, galleries, and shopping centers that draw people from all over. 5 years ago, we wanted to make Yonkers better. Working together, I think we did better than that. In fact, we did even more than that. Working together, we made Yonkers great. But we can't stop now. We have momentum, we have energy, we have the determination it takes to keep our city moving forward. Most of all, we have the people of Yonkers. We have pride in who we are and in our diversity. We stand together and respect one another, regardless of whether or not you're a family who's been here for five generations or 5 days. We stand for friendship with our neighbors, whether they are from Italy, Ireland, Mexico, Eastern Europe, South America, the West Indies, North Africa, or any other corner of the globe. But regardless of where we come from, we are all proud to say we are from Yonkers. Because we are a family that stands together, stands for respect, stands for hard work, and never loses faith in one another or in each other's ability to succeed. That's the family of Yonkers. That's my family. I hope it's your family too. May God bless you, and God bless the city of Yonkers. Thank you all, and have a good night.